I have a 9-volt battery right here, and what we're going to do in this video is to create a mathematical model of this battery. Specifically, we're going to model it as a Thevenin equivalent source in series with a Thevenin equivalent resistor. The question is, how are we going to do it? There's not an actual resistor inside that battery. I can't open up the battery and put an ohmmeter on it to measure it. What we're going to do is create a mathematical model of the battery by measuring how the voltage of this battery changes when I attach it to various loads. First, let's measure the open circuit voltage of the battery. It's a fairly new battery, and I'm measuring 9.22 volts as the open circuit voltage. I have four other resistors right here in sequence from large to small. We're going to start with the largest resistor, 1 kilo ohm, and we'll see what the voltage drop across this resistor is when I hook it up to the battery. When hooked up to the resistor, it looks like the voltage has dropped to 9.07 volts. The next resistor I have here is 220 ohms. Our voltage is now 8.84 volts. Next, we have a 150 ohm resistor. 8.73 volts. Finally, I have a 100 ohm resistor. Our voltage is 8.55 volts. I think it's already clear that this battery is not perfect. As we lower down the resistance connected to it, we notice that the voltage starts to fall. Let's use this information in order to create our mathematical model. First, let's calculate the current that was flowing out of the battery in each case. We can use Ohm's law to find the current that was flowing in all four of these cases. Now that we have the current and voltage that was flowing out of the battery, let's make a plot of voltage versus current for this particular battery. First of all, when we measured the open circuit voltage, no current was flowing. We then measured 9 milliamps. Then we measured 40 milliamps. We then measured 58 milliamps. And finally, we measured 86 milliamps. What you notice is that we have something that looks almost like a linear relationship between voltage and current. Let's go ahead and plot this in a more rigorous way so that this relationship is clear. From the plot, we can establish a trend line and see the relationship between current and voltage if we model it as a straight line. The voltage is negative 8.26 times the current plus 9.22. You can verify that if we plug a current of 0 in this equation, we'll wind up with an open circuit voltage of 9.22 volts. Let's return to our mathematical model and let me label the current. We now have a relationship between the two voltages in the diagram and the current. We wind up with V equals minus the Thevenin equivalent resistance times I plus the Thevenin equivalent voltage. If we compare the equation that I just derived with the equation we got from the graph, we can immediately see that these equations are of the same form. Therefore, the Thevenin equivalent voltage of our 9-volt battery right here is 9.22 volts. And the Thevenin equivalent resistance for this 9-volt battery is 8.26 ohms. We can make a plot of the voltage versus current for any source, and as long as that plot works out to be relatively linear, then we can use the Thevenin equivalent source and resistance to create a mathematical model for that source, just like we did with the 9-volt battery right here. If you enjoyed watching this video, then you might be interested in following our playlist and learning more about the fundamentals of electrical circuits.